And you know, we got an Alcani sheriff, Paul Bebeau, joining us. Paul, always good to see you. We're told that immigration consistently, illegal immigration, more to the point, consistently ranked top among Arizona voters on the left and right. I'm thinking of who's made that a signature issue, and that has been Donald Trump. So are the big crowds, maybe the developments in Brussels today, the wind at Donald Trump's back, and so far as he comes back and says, I warned you, I told you, what?
Definitely Donald Trump has made this his signature issue. And it's not just an Arizona issue. This is a national issue because all the illegals that come through my state of Arizona, the drug smuggling, you heard talk up in New Hampshire about heroin. Where do we think that's coming from? It's coming through this unsecured border and the methamphetamine, the cocaine, not just the marijuana. So this is connected to the rest of the country and they're feeling it. And people are sick and tired of the lawlessness and the lack of enforcement by our own government, putting people from foreign countries ahead of us. So I think, Donald Trump, you're going to see the results very shortly here on your show that I believe that he's going to win with an overwhelming victory.
Do you have any idea when that would be?
We're going to get it to you shortly. I was just talking with Michelle Reagan, who's our great Secretary of State.
She says within an hour. I think you can kind of cut some corners for us, but I don't want you to do that on air.
Yeah.
Sheriff, if you don't mind, I'm going to bring my colleagues and friends into this, beginning with Kennedy.
Of course. Yeah.
Kennedy, one of the things we keep talking about is how this issue is a consistently high issue. That was even before.
Yeah.
Long before. Brussels, long before Paris.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. And one of the things I'm most curious about tonight is to see how these voters are responding to the attacks and if that galvanizes any of, some apathetic voters who are going to sit out and if it changes the way that people vote. And obviously, when, you know, we have big events like this, you turn to the people who are, you know, probably going, one of them is going to be leading us here in short order. And how are they responding? And does that resonate with voters at the last minute? And also, you know, Donald Trump he's making his case that the border crisis, as he claims, and keeping people out is paramount to our national security. There are plenty of other people who can poke holes in that argument. But if that resonates with voters, especially in places like Arizona, border states, obviously very different than the rest of the country, then, I think you will see some things going even more so in his favor than we've seen in the polls.
All right. I'm going to bring my colleagues into this. But, Sheriff, I mean, that could explain the long lines, right? I mean, people are ticked off, right?
There's a logistical, people are angry, I'm angry, but there's a logistical issue. We had consolidated polling here in my state. So I was in Saddlebrook and three precincts all voted in one place. So in Maricopa County, the largest county, 60% of the votes in my state, 200 polls locations from 4 years ago, now we're consolidated into 60. So yes, there's a huge uptick in turnout. There's prediction. Michelle Reagan told me she's expecting up to 65%+ voter turnout today, which is unheard of in a primary. So you got long lines, but you've got fewer polling locations to actually vote.
For comparison, the highest in Arizona's history so far was just 51%.
Is that right?
When the state senator John McCain was running for the nomination back in 2008. So that is a huge jump. And even in counties like Maricopa County, as of the middle of the day yesterday, about 39% or 40% of Republicans in the state in Maricopa County had already cast ballots. So 277,000 out of 700,000, which is a huge percentage early voting.
You also have that long run-up to the primary. So you still have Ben Carson and Marco Rubio on those ballots to make things more interesting. But for people who haven't voted, today's a very different day.
Can I just ask Sheriff Bebeau a question?
Yes.
Sheriff, we've talked about this before, the authenticity of Trump. You may not like what he says, but you can't doubt his sincerity behind it, at least when he says it at the moment. And when you hear Cruz talking about the border, you sense there's a little bit of catch-up. He's trying to catch up to where Trump is, whether he's talking about the wall or some other issue regarding immigration. Is Trump seen as the more sincere purveyor of the information about immigration, stopping immigration, holding our borders tight, as opposed to Cruz?
Yes. Yes, and the reason why is he's shaped this conversation. And whoever shapes a conversation controls the debate and the narrative and is therefore has far more credibility on this issue because he's driven this issue. And you put on the other side Hillary Clinton just a week ago saying that she's going to put all 12 to 20 million illegals on an actual path to citizenship. So you couldn't have a starker contrast. Obama hasn't even said that. So we've got everything's on the line in this election. So Republicans, all Americans are very worried about what's going to happen here.
All right, Sheriff, I want to thank you very, very much. Well, we're getting some...